Okay. All right, all right. The diehard 1 million Cubs fans are here.
Yes, we are.
David Zimmerman, I didn't recognize you without your with your glasses on. Good. Lonskett Mounts, Dean of Business School. Welcome to 1 million Cubs, Brunswick, which is in the newspaper today.
Why?
Well, I read something about us. And I don't remember what it was, but it's still there. So, good. No, it was about May 5th when we had our fifth year, and the importance of this, and the importance of that, and the importance of our true best host in the whole world. Thank you. So, the idea behind this is we support entrepreneurship by having entrepreneurs get up and talk about themselves, because every entrepreneur has a story. And it is out of those stories that we learn about entrepreneurship, and we learn that we may have stories too, which encourage us to be entrepreneurial as well. So I'm glad you all are here. Our first presenter is, I'll just let her explain what she means by her workers have to know how to use a clutch. Kate Dart. Mayor C. Bouquet Flower Truck. Please come on.
Yeah, that's a great pronunciation. Hey, y'all. How are you?
Morning.
I'm Kate Dart. I'm so pleased to be here. This is great to be Skip. Like you said, I'm the owner of the Mercy Bouquet Flower Truck. I'm sure some of y'all see me driving around. So we've got that vintage blue Volkswagen. She's a 1960. And yes, she's a manual. So I told Skip the other day that I had to lower kind of my standards of looking for people to help me out because no one knows how to drive stick shift anymore. So that's been a little bit, interesting. I'll just start from the beginning, kind of share where the idea came from and go from there. So kind of just fell into my lap. I grew up in Costa Rica, actually. I lived there from the time I was 5 until I was 10. I'm sorry, 15. Gosh, 10 years. And I just remember, living there, we'd drive to the beach, and there would be these families selling these beautiful tropical flowers on the sides of the road, just crates and crates full of the birds of paradise and the lobster claw and California. You would pull up and, they just cut them from their farm and get them for pennies on the dollar. And it was just such a fun experience and something I really just loved doing when I was younger. And so I've been in the Golden Isles now for about, I'd say a little over 10 years. I married a native son, and so I followed him down here. And it was about 2019, I was talking with my mom and we were remembering about, the flowers on the side of the road and she said, we don't really have that here. We have grocery store flowers and then we've got some incredible floral designers. I mean, we're very lucky to have incredible floral designers as a huge wedding destination around here. But there's no roadside flowers, there's no flowers as an experience. And so, looked into that idea and I saw that there's this surge of women around the country who have started selling flowers out of a vintage truck, whether it be a Volkswagen or a vintage mail truck, what have you. And so the idea just kind of grew from there. So I started looking online and we knew it had to be a vintage truck. We knew we wanted that experience. And so we happened upon a website that was dedicated to just buying and selling more Volkswagens. There was a couple in Michigan that had tried to start a flower truck business and they were moving on because they were in Michigan and they could only be open 3 months out of the year. And so we found this truck up in Michigan, we shipped her down here. We really didn't have to do a whole lot to her. It was already set up, to hold the flower buckets and everything. And so I got her down here in October 2019. WEC, the Women's Entrepreneurship Summit over on Sea Island. They had us come out to their welcome party, and we pulled the truck up, almost stalled out four times that night. And we just made bouquets for all the ladies there, and it was so great. I didn't have any real plans. I didn't know where we were going to go. I just knew that we were going to have fun, and we wanted to connect with the community. Of course, as we all know, later that the next month, things started changing. So it was an interesting time. I had to learn how to pivot very quickly, very early on in my business. We couldn't go out for the first few months, so we just sat there. But it was a good learning time. I was reaching out to people, learning what they wanted to see from us. And I don't think I realized what a unique opportunity I had on my hands. The truck was outside, so that was a big plus, and it was an experience. I think there's a shift towards more experience-driven businesses, or people want to experience things, right? It wasn't just going to your grocery store and just grabbing some flowers and getting pre-arranged. They loved coming, they loved talking about the truck. I loved hearing, everyone has a story with VW. I mean, as much as the flowers or the stars, so is the truck. So I love having people tell me about, you know, their uncle, and they traveled across the country in a VW van. And that's been one of the highlights and joys of the business, is just sharing their stories with everyone. But then teaching people about flowers, teaching them about how to care for flowers. I love, one of my favorite parts is when people come up to me and say, Kate, I followed your tips, and I had someone just text me the other day, my flowers have lasted for 24 days. And so they just followed all the tips I gave them. And so that was really special for me. So we haven't been doing this as long, but I'm realizing that, you know, you've got to roll with the punches. We've been doing markets. We love getting out there doing markets. We do our pop-ups. That's our normal day-to-day. We're out from about Wednesday through Saturday at different places around the island and in Brunswick. And then we're also starting to look at private events, so hiring the truck to come to your wedding or come to a birthday party, where we take the truck loaded with the blooms, and you get to create a bouquet, have that bouquet making experience in the comfort of your front door. We've done flower crown making parties for little girls, and then as far as weddings, we just did a wedding where we showed up at the venue and the bridesmaids got to make their own bouquets at their truck, and then it was a great photo opportunity. And then the bride came out and she made her bouquet, and so we're learning all the new, fun, special, unique ways we can incorporate the truck and the flowers into all of our occupations. And it's definitely still a learning experience. I'm in the process of growing right now, scaling and growing. And we have a second truck. It's the same body style, 1963. That has been a learning experience in and of itself. It's been in the shop since, I think, October of last year. But I'm hoping that it gets out on the road this summer. And so we're hoping that with two trucks, we can reach more people, have more chances to be at events, and also reach new markets. We bought a trailer, an enclosed trailer. If anyone's been behind me on Frederica Road, you will know that the truck doesn't go very fast. I joke that maybe going downhill on a windy day, I can get her up to 39 miles an hour. But with this enclosed trailer, what we're hoping is we can load her up, take her to Savannah, sometimes people don't know, well, okay, college, what does that mean? You know, so just letting them know we're here, that you can come up to us, you know, find us at a pop-up, find us through Instagram right now is the best way to see where we're going to be. And, you know, just spread the word, I think, and just let people know that we're not just pop-ups. We can be there for private events. We can be at your parties, at your special occasions. There's nothing I really want to say no to, you know. If you know, just need a few steps, you know, hey, you know, Vanessa just said, I know I need eucalyptus this weekend. I can get that for you. So, and I'm always here. I tell everyone, you can always text or email me at any time, and if you need help, I can't remember, Kate, what you say, how do I take care of this flower? I love doing that. So just reach out, connect, and share with her, I think, right now.
I have another question.
Yes.
Does your truck have a name?
It does.
Because it was, it's sort of cool to call it the truck.
The truck. Thank you. And you know, that is a very good question. Her name is Indy. So when we first got her, Indy, and it's short for indigo.
Oh.
The blue purple flower, because the truck is that blue purple color. When we first got her, that was one of the first big sort of Instagram driven engaging. Events that we did. So we had people put in their best option for the name, and then the winner got a free bouquet. And actually, the little girl from Savannah is the one who chose Indigo, and she said, oh, and you can call her Indy. So we loved it. So her name is Miss Indy, and that's how we normally refer to her. And then with our second truck, she's yet to be painted, but once she's painted, we're going to do the same thing. We're going to throw her out there and say, name this truck. Whoever picks the winning name is going to get a free bouquet. So we like having the
Did you already share the tip on how to make flowers last 24 days?
Can I share that? Absolutely.
Please.
Yes, I'd love to. So this is what we tell everybody. When you come to the truck, I say there's really no big secret. You know, I've had people say, okay, I've got the aspirin, I've got the pennies, I've got the vodka, you're telling me. And like, vodka, that's for something else. You save that. Don't waste it on your flowers. The big secret, changing your water every day. It's a little bit of work, I know, but if you put the work in, I'm telling you. What it does is it just keeps that bacteria from growing in the water. You want to keep your water cold and clean. And then when you're arranging your flowers, you'll notice that some of those stems have the little leaves or petals that kind of go down the stalk. And you just want to make sure that you take all those off. You want nothing below your waterline when you're arranging your flowers. Again, that's just going to cause bacteria to grow. If you've ever left your flowers in there and you notice that the water's gotten that murky green, that's what's happening. That bacteria is growing. So just take off any of those leaves below your waterline. And then thirdly, what I like to tell people is keep it away from heat. Heat's the enemy of flowers, right? So no direct heat, no direct sunlight. Cooler is always better. Some fun tips. I know a favorite flower for a lot of us is the hydrangea. So with hydrangeas, a lot of people don't know that they drink from their petals as well as they do from their stems. So what I like to tell people is douse their heads liberally and often with cold water. I mean, really want to soak it. Some people dip their heads, you know, the whole head underwater. I've got a little spray bottle, and I'll get some ice water and just cover it. Now, what I like to do with my hydrangeas, and this also works for roses, is at night I'll put them in the fridge. So if you've got a fridge that doesn't run to supposed to be out this spring, and it's been pushed back and pushed back. Unfortunately, with COVID, a lot of these parts we've had to order from California, and shipping is taking forever. Actually, I just ordered the canopy. I had to order that from England. And so that's been a learning curve with these vintage vehicles, is finding the parts, where are they from, you know, what's going to fit. But I've been told that, you know, we're at the finish line. So I'm hoping to get it painted and, you know, just really get it out there. In a perfect world, end of June, beginning of July, preferably by July 4th.
And would you like to start participating in the farmer's market here at Mary Ross on Saturdays?
I would. We love farmer's markets.
And First Friday.
And First Friday, yes. And we've done a few First Fridays, and we love the energy. It's great. I mean, absolutely. And now that we have the trailer, you know, you've seen us sometimes going over the causeway. She's not a huge fan of hills. I feel very bad for people wanting me on the causeway because I put her in third gear and, you know, 25 miles an hour going over there. But now that we have the trailer, I can load her up in there and, you know, we can zip around. And but any of those events, I mean, that's our bread and butter, is going to these community events popping up and, you know, exactly just like that. So, yes, absolutely.
It doesn't make you so mad when you're behind you, though, because it's pretty, it's happy.
That's good. I'm glad.
Yeah.
We leave that happy road going.
It's happy. It's like, I've been behind you before, yeah, and it's like, it's the flower truck. It's okay.
I need to spread that around, too, because I've had a few people and I've stalled that one for a break a few times. Oh. Just held up truck, and I try to get back. But the good thing is she's very light, so I can't just push her to the side, you know, and let people know. Are you okay? Yeah, she does this.
So how do you deal with inventory issue? Do you sell all your flowers before you can ever, you know, have to?
So, and that's something, I would say inventory is definitely something that we've had to learn. And
where do you get them from?
So we source them. We have wholesalers really in Florida, Miami, and right now, but the flowers themselves come from all over. In an ideal world, I would love to source from the U.S., but right now we source from the U.S., the West Coast, the East Coast, Canada, Central, South America, and then a lot of flowers come in from Europe and Holland. So we really get them from all over the world. But inventory is an interesting question, actually. It's, learning supply and demand, and then also within the flower industry, has affected, you know, But we do, you know, we really do enjoy having, you know, those guys come up and say, you know, maybe something, and then we can, you know, I like teaching them a little bit, you know, getting them involved and saying, listen, you know, come pick out, and we come up with something, and they're so happy, I think it's great when we can, you know, be with everybody, right? So we're here, and we say that, we say, you know, it's a DIY flower bar, we say, it's also about STEM, and our pop-ups. But we're here to help you too. If you don't want to do that, we can help you out. We can make it for you as well. Yes, sir.
Is your standard mock-up, or do you have a different mock-up for each flower?
It depends. So our flowers every week it changes based on availability, seasonality. Like I said, when roses were really hard to come by, I passed on roses that week. Ones that you could get, at least from that area, were just astronomical. And so I tried to find a nice middle ground. We are a boutique. You know, I've had some people come by and say, well, if you're a cedar, you know, this flower's a little bit cheaper. Completely understand that. However, Mark, you don't have the buying power here at cedar. You know, we're a small business, we're a boutique. We're not here at cedar, but we're not going to be the prices of your, you know, extravagant floral flowers, right? So I think we found a good middle ground. I know, you know, I think I found where people are comfortable. And, you know, I try to keep it as standard as possible. Now, the prices might fluctuate a few cents here and there, up or down, just depending, again, on seasonality and availability. But we try to stay, you know, at a level where people are comfortable. You know? And, So far,
how do we reach you to book you?
Yeah.
Great question. You can call me directly at my cell phone number or 912-506-3532. Or you can email hello@mercybouquetflowertruck.com.
Any other questions?
Spell it. I was writing that one down.
And hello at Mercy, MercyBouquet flowertruck.com.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you guys so much.
Well, let's take a little break and then we'll have our next.
I'd love to have her.
Yes.
I've seen her when Moxie crafted.